Terry, that ad from a political action group claims Justice Prosser failed to prosecute that priest more than 30 years ago when Prosser was a district attorney. But today, Prosser and his supporters say the ad is misleading and deceptive. They're demanding that it be pulled, and they want Prosser's opponent to demand the same.
It's the ad that supporters of Justice David Prosser say has brought the Supreme Court race to a new low.
A priest sexually abuses children for 30 years across Wisconsin. A mother tells DA David Prosser her two young sons were sexually assaulted. What does Prosser do? Prosser refuses to prosecute.
It involves Prosser's decision in 1979 not to prosecute a then-Catholic priest, John Patrick Feeney, accused of molesting two young brothers. Justice Prosser told Upfront's Mike Goucher that he didn't prosecute because it was a weak case and said new information came to light when the case went to trial more than 20 years later. Information Prosser says he didn't know at the time.
Well, there really was a first-degree sexual assault, but I didn't know about that. There was no first-degree sexual assault that I ever heard about.
In an email obtained by 12 News on Thursday, one of the victims in the case, Troy Merrifield, wrote that he finds the ad offensive, inaccurate, and out of context, and says he hopes the organization will remove the ad. Prosser supporters gathered in Waukesha County today to make the same demand.
I hope that prosecutors statewide are going to join me in condemning this ad, and I hope that Justice Prosser's opponent will join us in condemning this ad and demanding that it be taken off the airwaves.
12 News contacted the campaign of Prosser's opponent, Joanne Kloppenburg, a spokesperson telling us only, "It's not our ad and we have no comment." But former justice and current Marquette Law School professor Janine Geske says she finds the ad disturbing.
It's sad because it's going to the lowest common denominator in terms of the election as opposed to looking at the qualifications of the two candidates and deciding which candidate would be the best justice for the court.
The group running that ad, the Greater Wisconsin Committee, says it stands by the ad and does not intend to pull it off the air. And the topic is likely to come up when the two Supreme Court candidates face off in a debate later tonight in Madison. We'll have coverage of that tonight at 10.